Hey there, welcome to another edition of Sky High History, where you get a bite-sized history lesson seen from a bird's eye view. Today we're covering the American Tobacco Company, specifically their Lucky Strike factory in Durham, North Carolina. So, let's get started. In 1874, Washington Duke, a Confederate Army veteran, and his two sons, Benjamin and James Buchanan Duke, built a factory, and by 1878 had formed the firm W. Duke Sons & Company, which was one of the first tobacco companies to use cigarette manufacturing machines. The Dukes then established the American Tobacco Company in 1890 as they entered the cigarette war, with James as the company's president. Mergers and purchases saw the Dukes eventually in corporate control of practically the entire American tobacco industry, an empire of 150 factories in total. After litigation in 1911, it was decided the tobacco trust the Dukes had built was in violation of the Sherman Antitrust Act and, as a result, eventually dissolved. After this was determined, R.J. Reynolds, Liggett & Myers, and Lorillard came to the front of the pack as the main cigarette manufacturers alongside the American Tobacco Company. In 1916, American Tobacco introduced what would be its most popular cigarette brand in the Lucky Strike, followed shortly by a king-size cigarette called the Pall Mall. The sale of these brands resulted in American Tobacco being the most successful cigarette manufacturer of the World War II era. However, failing to develop a strong filter cigarette in the 1950s resulted in a fall from one of the big fish in the tobacco industry to being just a minor presence. After further dilution and diversification throughout the 20th century, American Tobacco was renamed to American Brands in 1969 and then became Fortune Brands before finally walking away from the tobacco industry. Today, the American Tobacco Company's Durham, North Carolina campus hosts a bevy of restaurants and offices. The facility offers a unique combination of modern stylings and industrial-era architecture that would charm just about any visitor, and sits just across the street from the stadium of the local minor league baseball team, the Durham Bulls. Today, like any other day, I hope you learned something new. If you did, please take the time to give me a like, and don't forget to hit that subscribe button while you're down there. It helps me out a lot as we're on the quest for 1,000 subscribers. If you really love my videos, hit the bell icon next to the subscribe button to get notifications every time I post a new video. Until next time, this is Chris, the drone geek of Lancaster, telling you to have a nice day.